here we are at the National Corvette Museum, baby. Nothing but Chevy. That's Corvette, CORVETTE. You see, Chevrolet,
the greatest line of car manufacturing in the world. What a bed on that car. That is nice.
And here you have the 2015 Chevy Corvette, in which, if it wasn't against the law, I would steal.
Here we're following Frank.
Get out of the candy store.
Hey, you got automatic doors. This car was owned by the famous Roy Kelton Big O Orbison. It is a 1967 Candy Apple Red Corvette. This was the last Corvette that Mr. Orbison ever purchased before he died. This also is the newest addition to the Corvette Museum.
This particular Corvette you see here is a 1953. It was the first year that Corvettes were produced. Only 300 were ever built. They only came in the polo white that you saw. As a matter of fact, also something else unique about these Corvettes are famous for being built here in Kentucky. This is the only model that was ever built outside of Kentucky. It was actually built in a place called Fendt, Michigan.
The man that owned this car drove prototypes for GM all through his life, and never owned a Corvette until he retired, and he got this 1974 fully loaded Corvette. The man's name was Zorro Arkus Duntoff.
Here you've seen a display of three different Corvettes that all come from the late 50s to the 1960 model Corvette. One thing you'll notice different is from the previous 1953 model that we looked at earlier is the original. These all have an upgraded front style with more raised headlights and a more distinct profile in the front. That was one of the most iconic parts of these new models. There are three different ones here. We have a 60, a 57, and a 56.
Here we have the underpinnings of the 1973 convertible.
Here we have a variety of different Corvettes that have been used as race cars instead of just regular production cars. And here's a even wider array of motors that were used in the cars.
Here's a slowed down video of how the engine works. The LT1 Corvette engine.
This particular Corvette here is a 2012 ZR1. It's actually the world record car, the one that was set the world record. The video above is this particular Corvette going around a racetrack in Germany known as the Nürburgring. It's a racetrack that is world renowned for car companies testing their vehicles there. It's one of the toughest tracks in the world, and this is actually where the Corvette set its world record at. These particular Corvettes that you've just seen here are all concept cars. They were vehicles that were never actually made by General Motors. They were designed simply for studies to see how well the Corvette could be made in its proper production form. This one here is a 68 Astrovet. Its entire purpose was to see how slippery and how aerodynamic they could make the Corvette to make it faster.
This is the 1983 Corvette, and to this day, this is the only one existing out of 43 made.
These three not so real men you see here are all three probably the most important people, influential people that were involved in the entire Corvette line. You have Jerry Palmer and Larry Shinoda and John Cafaro. They were all very important in the beginning. Larry actually was the chief designer of the 53 Corvette, the very first one. He sort of paved the way for the rest of Corvette history. The other two were both designers as well and had major impacts on the way Corvettes are made. Accident was. We want to have a moment of silence because of Frank's request for these cars. Here you have the GS90 Corvette. There's only six of these that have ever been built, and they cost $134,500. As you can see, it's kind of an older vehicle, but still, with its age, it still has 475 horsepower, which is extremely fast even by today's standards. We're here with Katie and Bowen Green at the National Corvette Museum. She's the head of the communications department here. And Katie, what's so special about the Corvette Museum that makes it so important to Kentucky historically?
Corvettes have been made in Kentucky since 1981, when production moved from St. Louis, Missouri to Bowling Green. Corvette has only been made in three places ever in its history. The first 53 Corvettes were made in Flint, Michigan, then 54 to 81 in St. Louis, and then from 81 to the present in Bowling Green. In 1994, the National Corvette Museum opened, so this year we're celebrating our 20th anniversary. Corvette is America's only sports car, and for it to only be made right here in the state of Kentucky is pretty significant.
We're here with Don Moore and his wife. They're from Tampa, Florida. And Don, what brought you all to the Corvette Museum?
Well, we came up to visit family in Paducah, Kentucky, and I'm a Corvette owner, so we decided to come over for the day to see the museum.
So you're a big Corvette enthusiast?
Yeah, have been for a long time.
Thank you. Appreciate
you're
it.
You're welcome. Thank you.
National Corvette Museum, we have the one and only Mr. Zora Arkus Duntov, and he had a lot of things to do with the making of the Corvette. Sir, would you like to say a few choice words this evening?
Yes, thank you. I appreciate y'all getting to come out to the Corvette Museum today and see all the nice cars. As you said, I was known as the father of the Corvette, and one in particular I'd like to show you all is my personal Corvette, the 1974 Stingray that you see behind you there.
If you could make any changes from back in the day, what would they be about the Corvette?
The only thing I would change would be to make the car a lot faster.
Thank you very much for your time.
You're welcome.
Codger.
This is the result of Chandler trying to ask a man if he could interview him a little bit. The man said
no. Here you have the Corvette crash site, and this is what will happen if Chandler keeps driving the way he does. This is what will happen to his car.
Yes, because on the way up here, I'm the one who got pulled over.
Miss Daniel Boone! Woo! Thank you!
And you'll see your classmate, Jared, partying with Corvette in this wonderful little machine.
Jared in his natural habitat.
It's a mock assembly line of Corvettes.
This is where you put the cars together. Only Jared is having very hard trouble with it.
Yeah, and 2 wheels. Great. One ram. How about a blue? Remember, that's a red truck. Take it through. Keep watching the red truck. It'll come back and it won't have no wheels on.
There they go. They missed the bucket.
Ladies and gentlemen, you're looking at the one and only 66 Daniel Boone annual winner. The one and only Corvette.
Kiyosabe, of course it's me, better known as the Master G. A fucking new squad, sense the danger. When it's stung by the rapping ranger. Had a little talk with my medicine man. He said, get them squads fast educate. To all you girls that wanna join my tribe, just move to my rhythm and feel my vibe. Put up a fuss in the end, you'll agree. But when you come inside, my TV.